Rick's going to try to find some cups.
Thank you. 1 o'clock in the morning on Hollywood Boulevard.
You ever been to Hollywood?
Oh yeah.
How many times?
One time. That was enough.
Yeah.
I was there for like 2 weeks.
What'd you do?
Oh, just did everything I could do there. Went around every street at night, every club. Met a lot of cool musicians, cool people. Met a lot of just people.
Yeah.
And went to the NAMM show last year in Anaheim, California.
Wow,
I stayed in Burbank, in California, and at a friend's house. Went to every place in Los Angeles I could go.
You know, the Roxy.
I was a tourist. What's that?
Roxy.
Yeah.
Right. How about
China Club?
China Club.
Yeah.
You like that?
Yeah, China Club was cool. They had a jam session that Monday night, actually.
Yeah? Did you play?
No, I took my axe down. I thought I was going to get to sit in. But the guy that was hosting the jam was some like hot blues keyboard player in LA, and he brings in big name people to play with him.
Right, sure.
And he got to like call 2 weeks in advance and let him know you're coming, and he'll send you charts above all. And I thought it was a jam session, man. It was advertised in the paper, jam session. In big letters, JAM session. No reading of it. But he had charts up there. He said that the week before I was there. Or even Franklin was there. Well, I found Franklin. She was pretty cool, I guess.
Who was there that night?
Guitar player from Bruce Horney and the Range. Bass player of Tonight Show Band. I keep forgetting his name. Some drummer from P.I.T., I guess. Some chick percussionist that was hot, man. She was really good. And two chick singers and another guitar player. These people sitting there left and right. They had a 3-drink minimum.
Yeah?
So you had to get drunk before you got out of the club. No way, they wouldn't let you go. Then the day after that, we went to the baked potato. Lost Lobotomies. That's Stick Luke, there is new fusion band. That's pretty cool. They had Carlos Vega, Lenny Castro, David Garfield on keyboard, Jimmy Johnson on bass, and Steve Luke.
Did you get to talk to any of those people?
Yeah, I talked to all of them. I saw them at the NAMM show too, the week later. And some of them remembered me like that night. And the wildest thing that happened in the club that night, after this, we saw the second show, which was later show. The thing that happened is
Marcus Miller and Joe Sample walked in the club. And Marcus was carrying his bass and was coming for that week for the NAMM show anyway. And so they made him sit in. My camera. So they made him sit in. I saw like two of my favorite bass players on the same night.
Cool.
It was fun. Did you want to
meet Frank Cavalli again?
Yeah.
Talked to him for a while.
When did you meet him the first time?
In Kansas City.
Yeah.
Went up for his plane. That was fun.
You want to live in LA? Play there?
Yeah. I spent the first 3 years of his career playing country music with the country band. Before he joined the career instrument. I said, well, hey man, that's kind of a jump. He goes, yeah. I'll play jazz.
Schedule.
Quarter after.